Joining us now, five-time Grammy Award winner and member of the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame, James Taylor. James is out with a new album of original songs called Before This World. Absolutely beautiful covers.
Exciting.
Look at the vinyl,
Joe. I get the vinyl. Thank God.
Joe is very happy about this.
I know it.
Takes me back, baby.
It takes me back.
Pull it out.
It's reality.
It's, the actual, this,
come on.
I think this version is actually clear vinyl.
It's, no,
yes,
really?
I've never seen that before.
Oh, look at that.
Oh, God. Look at us, and we're not even talking about the music.
No, don't play it.
The actual. That's
so
cool.
Your first album of original songs in a dozen years?
It has been a while, yeah.
Wow. When did you make the decision that you were ready to do it again?
Actually, I've been sort of trying to focus on it for about 5 years, but I finally got serious in 2013. I took a good part of the year off and got down to writing.
How was it different working with the notepad as James Taylor than it was 30 years ago when you were starting out?
Yeah, that's a good question. It's like 30 years ago, these things were, I couldn't keep them in.
Right.
You know, they're just being squeezed out, forced out at every, I was writing all the time, no matter what. But now I have to really court the muse.
Mike Barnicle's here with us. And Mike, usually we're talking about the Barnicle Boys as like the hooligans or the rapscallions that they are. But they've done something to contribute here that's pretty amazing.
They did, at James's request, I believe, they did a video for the song about Fenway Park.
This is a song, Angels of Fenway, is about the 2004 series, that miracle series in the playoffs, the wild card position that the Boston Red Sox had, and the series against the Yankees when they were down 3 and needed to win 4 in a row, an impossible task. You know, pretty much everybody had given up on it. And just what that was like to be in New England, to witness the end of the curse of the Bambino, it was such a moment, an incredible thing that people have been waiting for generations, that I knew I wanted to write about it. The Red Sox sort of embraced the song and wanted to, there was a weekend series with the Yankees, they wanted to sort of present the song and me a favor too and help me sort of release it. So
it was a great night there. It really was. I remember looking down, you flying, and then looking up at the moon rising. I said, it just doesn't get any better than this. Here's a clip of the video.
Oh, damn them Yankees, outspending everybody 2-1, picking up on the cream of the crop, stealing everyone's favorite son.
Angels of
be proud. Those boys done good, Mike. That looks great.
Remarkable. You listen to music when you're in the car?
Yeah, I do. Unless I'm writing, and then I often write lyrics, and Sweet Baby James was written, on the turnpike from Stockbridge to Boston, and it's a good place to, before the cell phone, you were uninterrupted.
Yep.
You could
mull and really think.
Now there's not an instant.
No, I know. It follows you everywhere. You know, it's just so fascinating, and I mean, we're lucky that we have this, but it's so fascinating that I hear your songs either on XM, the 70s channel, or on the bridge. I hear your songs more now than I did in 1974, 75. It's pretty remarkable the way that works. I mean, the songs stay alive and they're vibrant and they're getting as much airplay today as they did in the 70s.
You know, I keep waiting for it to end, but
yeah.
as long as the audience shows up, we're going to go out on the road again.
James Taylor, it's a great, great honor to have you here. What a great honor for all of us. We thank you for coming. The album is Before This World, and extraordinary. I'm going to get it on vinyl. It's just absolutely beautiful. Thank you so much for being with us. We greatly appreciate it.
We'll be right back with much more Morning Joe.
Like a hungry dog.